Hello, I'm Simon Ebert. I'm an engineer and a member of Huesker's Synthetics Applications Support Team. In this videocast, I'm going to explain how geotextile dewatering tubes work and where they are applied. Geotextile dewatering tubes lend themselves to use in all applications where sludge is produced. Water removal by means of dewatering tubes is based on the principle of filtration, achieved through the use of a special high-performance woven filter. The filtration process involves the mechanical separation of the solid and liquid phases of a suspension or material mix. Sludge comprises a mixture of fine particles and a liquid, the particles being finely distributed or suspended in the fluid. The suspended particles can be of either mineral or organic origin. Sludge accumulation in ponds, lakes, dam reservoirs, and other standing or flowing waters results from the sedimentation of solids, which is triggered by a reduction in flow speed and the accordingly lower transport capacity of the water. The sludge, also referred to as sediment, can bring about considerable functional and aesthetic problems in water bodies, watercourses, and hydraulic structures. These may ultimately impair operational performance or cause damage to the environment and health. Other types of sludge or sediment include the sewage sludge from sewage treatment plants, the industrial sludge produced by many industrial plants, and the infrastructural sludges from large construction sites. These types of sediment generally take the form of process sludge that requires dewatering. Mining residuals are a further field of application. As the vast quantities of sludge produced during the extraction of many raw materials are often highly polluted due to the mining and subsequent processing operations, they require dewatering and disposal. One method of dewatering large volumes of sludge is to pump it into lagoons or onto spoil areas. This, however, takes up very large areas of land. As a result, sludge is either directly removed from the site, which in turn entails a major logistical operation and a large ecological footprint, or dewatered by technical procedures. Technical dewatering typically requires the use of chamber filter presses, belt filter presses, or centrifuges, with high capital and maintenance cost as a consequence. Furthermore, as this equipment tends to be designed for smaller sludge quantities, large volumes inflate both the time and cost for dewatering the sludge. In many situations, the use of geotextile tubes for dewatering offers immense benefits. Compared to the previously mentioned methods, they can achieve shorter dewatering times for larger volumes. Large quantities of sludge can be pumped into these tubes within a relatively short space of time. The permeable fabric then allows the water to escape. The required water content is achieved after a certain waiting period, which depends on the type of sludge, and the dewatered sludge can then be removed from the tube and transported off-site. Advanced dewatering ensures that the quantity for removal is much smaller than the original sludge volume. The tube dewatering process can be broken down into four steps. The sludge is first extracted by means of a suction dredger or a large mobile dredging pump. In the second step, the sludge is conditioned through the addition of a flocculating agent that causes the suspended particles to clump together into larger flakes, also called flocs. After the sludge has been conditioned and has traveled a sufficiently long mixing distance, it is pumped into the dewatering tube. This is where the third step, the core process of dewatering, takes place. Here, static gravity drainage ensures the steady removal of water from the sludge. Through the continuous process of sludge consolidation, the water content in the dewatering tubes gradually decreases until it is ready for disposal in the fourth and final step. Permanent storage in the tube is an alternative option. The encapsulation of the sludge prevents it from being re-wetted, for example by rain, during the consolidation or permanent storage phase. This allows a higher dry residue quantity to be achieved than with spoil area dewatering. Dewatering tubes can be readily manufactured with a length of 65 meters and a perimeter of 28 meters to provide 1,650 cubic meters storage capacity. To ensure the controlled drainage of water from the tube during dewatering and to prevent erosion of the surrounding area, the base surface should be erosion resistant or provided with a drainage layer. On specific projects, depending on the available space and sludge properties, it may also be possible to stack tubes in several layers. Continuous refinements to the high-performance woven filter used for the tubes have made it possible to progressively boost dewatering performance over the last few years. To achieve a dewatered sludge volume of 60,000 cubic meters in situ sludge, or a dredge volume of 345,000 cubic meters within the same short period as a Soltane dewatering tube, it would be necessary to deploy around 12 centrifuges or 30 belt filter presses. Soltane tubes offer the combined advantages of rapid and space-saving dewatering for large and small sludge quantities, thus providing an innovative and practical solution in both ecological and financial terms. I hope that this presentation has captured your interest. Should you wish to know more about the technical details and Huesker's solutions, then please take a look at our website or contact us directly. We look forward to providing you with advice and support.